Welcome to the Pirate's Life.
Here we are at our sweet spot, about 7 nautical miles offshore, somewhere between American Shoal Light and the south end of Looe Key Reef. We've been tracking Goliath groupers for about a year now. We finally found them in a spot today where we could interact with them. Goliath groupers usually get about 8 feet and about 700 or 800 pounds when they're fully grown. Today in the family of four, we found one very large male that was about 3/4 the size of our boat. So I would say he was over that max size. He was probably about 9 feet and probably about 800 pounds. Goliath groupers are also called jewfish. Goliaths are critically threatened, so this has made it even harder to find them the way we did today. The U.S. started protecting them in 1990, which has helped their populations rebound from overfishing, spearfishing, and pollution. They also have a very slow growth rate. They're unable to reproduce until the males are about 4 to 6 years old and the females are around 6 to 8 years old. So this keeps their population pretty low, although they have rebounded pretty well. Goliaths are also known to attack divers, but we were in the water with four of them today for over an hour and we didn't have any problem. Here you can see the remora fish attached to the big grouper. The remoras are otherwise known as sucker fish, and they usually attach to bigger species of manta rays, whales, turtles, and larger sharks. So when you have a large grouper like this, sometimes they'll get them. As you can see, this one is about 2 to 3 feet long in itself, and that's about the max size that the suckerfish gets. Remora usually like tropical waters, so sometimes they don't make it up the coast unless they're attached to a larger species, and then they will find their way back to warmer water. They're pretty shy because they kept switching sides on us, you know, what side of the grouper. They would always go on the opposite side of the grouper to stay away from us. It's known that they do attach themselves to divers on occasion, but we didn't have any problems out of them today either.
barracuda.
Here you can see a bonnethead shark stuck in the shallows of low tide, trying to make it to deeper water. Hopefully I helped him out a little bit here. Bonnetheads are the smallest species in the family of the hammerheads. They only get about 3 to 5 feet long. Thanks for joining us on this episode, and remember, pirate up.